One of the amazing features within Final Cut Pro is the snap functionality. You ever drag a clip over and it goes right to the edge of the clip, maybe it's something above or below, that snap functionality. We're gonna show you how to turn it on and off right now. With snapping off, the playhead will not lock on to any points on the timeline. But let's say we're trying to match the edges of two clips together exactly. In that case, we should turn snapping on. In the top navigation, choose View and Snapping, or use the handy shortcut N. If you already have snapping turned on, you'll see a check mark next to it. This snapping button on the right of the timeline menu will also be highlighted in blue, and clicking on it is another quick way to turn snapping on or off. Now that we have snapping on, the playhead will automatically snap to points on the timeline. Whenever it snaps, it will turn bright yellow. We can snap to a clip's start or end points, as well as any intersections between clips. Notice that the playhead snaps to the edges of all clips in the timeline, not just the ones in the primary storyline. Snapping comes in handy when we are editing or positioning clips. As we zoom in, it's now clear that this title does not exactly line up with the edge of the clip. We can adjust it so that it matches exactly to the intersection point. Now the edges are lining up perfectly. Let's snap to the other edge as well. Imagine how long that would have taken without the snapping tool. And look how easy it is to snap the position of this clip to any point. Give it a try with editing tools like Blade or Range Selection to help you nail down those precise edits. The snapping tool is a must. Now you know how to turn it on, turn it off, and stop wiggling back and forth to find that perfect frame where your other clip begins. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
Like, share, and subscribe.